मॉर्निंग चिल्ड्रेन टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू सी सिक्स्थ स्टैंडर्ड इंग्लिश टर्म 3 यूनिट 1 लेसन 1 हू ओन्स द वाटर सेक्शन 2 ऑलरेडी वी हैव सीन सेक्शन 1 द स्टोरी इज अबाउट द होल यस द होल इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट इन द स्टोरी लेट अस सी व्हाट इज गोइंग टू हैपन इन सेक्शन 2 Before that, let us see some words and their meanings. Sniffed, to breathe in air in noisy way. Whined, made a high-pitched cry. Snarled, made a deep angry noise. Soaked, completely wet. Wallowed, to lie and roll in mud. Multitude, a large number of people. Hooves, hard part of the feet of the animals. Such as horse, sheep, deer, etc. Trampling, crushing. Let us get into the section 2. A pack of wild dogs catching the scent of boar in the wind came to the spot where he had lain. They sniffed the circle that was rich with the smell of the animal. They whined and snarled and dug at the smell as if digging the elusive boar himself out of the ground. Finally realizing that there was no dinner to be found there, they departed, their noses and tails high in the air, and in doing so, they left the hole a little bigger and wider than they had found it. In the beginning, the hole was very small. Then the little bird used it as a temporary nest. Then the wild boar made it comfortable for sitting there. So the hole was little bigger. Now a pack of wild dogs catching the scent of the wild boar came to the spot where the wild boar lay. They sniffed the circle that was rich with the smell of the animal. Sniffed means to breathe in air in a noisy way. They whined and snarled and dug at the smell as if digging the elusive boar himself out of the ground. Whined means made a high-pitched cry. Snarled means made a deep angry noise. By making a loud noise, they were digging the pit and they difficult to find the boar there. Elusive means difficult to find. Finally, they realized that there was no dinner. Yes, there was no animal. They left the hole a little bigger and wider than they had found it. Before when they come, the hole was little smaller. After digging, the hole became a little wider and bigger. And then what happened, you will ask? Do other animals come along too? They do indeed, my child. I told you the hole had a story to tell. You may think that, and then what happened? Actually, the story is about the hole. Already we have seen. Not long after, the rains came. It poured and poured, and only those of us who have seen the monsoons will know what that means. It rained without stopping for 3 days and 3 nights, and the dry earth soaked up the moisture as a hungry puppy laps up milk. Not long after, the rains came. It poured and poured. I think you have seen in the monsoon season. If it is heavy rains mean, what will happen? Yes, continuously it used to rain, isn't it? Yes. It rained for 3 days and 3 nights continuously. The land was very dry. Yes, already we have seen in section 1. So after raining, the dry air soaked up the moisture. As a hungry puppy laps up milk. The whole earth smelled wet and fresh, and even the normally serious looking people in the village went around with smiles on their faces. The hole in the ground collected the water that fell, and around its edges the grass grew a brighter green. Soon buffaloes discovered the grassy spot, and as buffaloes want to do, they wallowed in the puddly water, turning the hole into a muddy pit. After it rains, we also smell that wet and fresh. People looking so happy, a smile on their faces. The hole collected the water and the grass grew in their edges. The buffaloes found the grassy spot. Want to do, they wallowed. Wallowed means to lie in roll in the mud. So they wanted to roll in the mud, the puddly water. Some water collected in the pit. The buffaloes turned there. So the water turned into a muddy water. I was not there to see, but I am told that many afternoons did the buffaloes gather and thus with a multitude of hooves trampling the soil. The pit that was once a tiny depression widened and grew and became a little watering hole. After turning the hole into a muddy pit, many afternoons buffaloes gathered and with a multitude of hooves trampling the soil. Multitude means a large number. Trampling means crushing. So they were crushing the soil. Now the pit was widened and grew, become a little watering hole. And they all lived happily ever after. You will say in glee, but that rarely happens in real tales, my dear. There is more to go, so you will have to wait a while. And you can say in happiness, glee means happiness. All lived happily ever after, but rarely happens in real tales, my dear. There is no more to go, you have to wait a while. Yes, you have to wait for some time. It will be continued in next section 3. Children, I hope you all have understood section 2. We will continue in the next class in section 3. Thank you.